Go to scratch.mit.edu and a beautiful world called Scratch opens up, and then you can sign up if you are a scratcher, and then just click on create if you aren't or if it doesn't matter to you. And then here's the editor. Just bit by the old scratch card. Let's paint a sprite, or what you call custom sprite. Drag out a rectangle to cover up the stage. And let's give this splash of paint. I'm giving a nice pinkish red, for example, except green, as that is the color we are going to key our green screen into. Okay, now drag out curved points out of the left edge quite a few times to give it a nice wavy texture after selecting the reshape tool. Just shift the wavy side out with the reshape tool. Now with the codes tab, make a broadcast message like this and name it anything you like. Doesn't matter, you know. And under that head block, within two set size blocks, with the first one to any large number, basically to snap to the maximum size, and the second one to the normal sprite size, put the position to extreme right such that it is invisible. Oh, that works. Cool. From the looks tab, we'll grab in the switch costume to costume one block at first. Now separately, take a repeat on the block. First make a block by clicking on the make block button from the my blocks category and name it animate with two inputs x and y. Now here basically the repeat and will repeat till actual x position is the target x, and same for the y. Let me do my magic snap to complete the smooth block. Now try in the custom block into the main sprite and make it animate to 0x and 0y. And you can keep the smoothness value to whatever you want. Whoa, that was too quick. Let me increase the smoothness a little bit. That's just what I wanted. The curvy edge doesn't look good. Fixing time. Let's rename this costume and then duplicate it and change its fill color to something like blue. Again, all these colors are going to be of your choice. Now delete the curved points on the edge and then give them a different wavy texture in the same way as before. Now, before the animate block, put in the create a clone of myself block. And now what happens when a clone is created? So bring in the when I start as a clone block under it. And after switching the costume to do, duplicate the same animate block and decrease the smoothness value a bit. Now, so that all of this starts immediately when the green flag is clicked, connect a broadcast green screen started block with it. Now that is cool entrance effect. If you don't intend to make a green screen, you can even use this transition in other projects you make. Now let's make a new costume within the sprite, and in this one what we are going to do is we are just going to create random text. In fact, you can apply your own text for the green screen or just say any element you'd like to have in your green screen. Then you can just duplicate this costume. Actually, you could paint a new costume also and then delete the things we have in here and create a circle, centralize it, give it a nice elevation by duplicating it, duplicating the shape, auto offsets it by 5 pixels downright, and then set this copy pasted one to the back right after giving it a dark shade. What I'd like to put is a logo in here. You can put your own thing or just give any other element according what kind of green screen you're making. Now we bring in the pen extension by clicking the extreme bottom left blue button and then put in here the stamp block after the when I create clone of myself block, and then delete this clone block right after it. Now in the main broadcast receive quote head, we'll put the switch costume to random logo block, and then inside a repeat 10 block, a change size by 10 block. And also before that, we'll set the position to x 0 and y 50 and the size to 0. And yeah, we stamp the texture on before changing the costume. Stamp this logo after it transits And then let's bring the switch costume to random logo block in and change it to switch costume to text. Now bring in the animate block from the my blocks category and bring in size hack set for the switch costume to text block first, and then change the x position to -350 and y position to -50. Now change the animate blocks inputs to x0 and y -50 and the smoothness to whatever you want, maybe 3. So far so good. Change the logo bulbs to maybe change size by 24 5 times, and then put the erase all block at the top. Now in the backdrops, convert it to bitmap, select a green fill, and then with the fill bucket tool selected, click on the editor area to fill up the stage. Now convert it back to vector and let's first rename the sprite to green screen. And then duplicate any of the wavy texture and bring it below the others. Now select this hole, flip it horizontally and shift it right till the curves don't interfere with the main stage. Delete the previous curve points and make a new set of them. But again, make sure they don't interfere with the main stage. So let's go to the backdrops again and memorize the shade of green exactly. And now back to the sprite, change the fill of the latest costume which we had duplicated to that exact shade of green. Now back to the code step. Stamp after the text transition has taken place, and then put a weight block and its value according to your green screen. And then just duplicate from the first wave entrance transition till the first stamp. And then bring it down to our current wave and reverse the x position at the start to -600. Actually, it depends if you want to or keep the same. And maybe change the smoothness value of that animate block. Okay, so let me record all of it. Yep. And now in my video editor Power Director, I have a new project opened up right here, and I have imported that record of the green screen too. Let's bring it down to the video track and play it. Okay, so let me get the exact frame where the green screen starts. Yeah, right here. Trim it at that point with Ctrl T and delete the unnecessary former part. Now also at the exact frame where the green screen ends, we press Ctrl T to trim it and then delete the unnecessary succeeding part. Now we are left with the main ongoing green screen part. Now click on the Tools drop-down button and then on the Power Tools option from the settings that opens up. Select the Crop and Zoom option and click on Crop or Zoom. Now a window like this opens up. Drag in the resizing handles at the corner while the aspect ratio mode at the right is selected into the sole green screen part. And then click on the OK button. We have now cropped the white sides out, so select the Designer drop-down button and click on the PIP Designer option. Again, a window like this opens up. Scroll down and then select the Chroma Key checkbox. Then, with the eyedropper tool selected, simply pick the green color and press OK. Now your first-class green screen effect is ready. Time to put it on a separate background to test. A point to note here that while you have your video, an image or anything going on in the main track, your green screen video needs to be on the video track just below it. I'm so happy for how it turned out so well. Please drop a like if this turned out helpful, or maybe it will for others. So see you again on the next video. Bye till then.